In this video, we're going to go through step-by-step how to create this unique poster design in Adobe Photoshop. All right, first gather three images that you want to put into your background. This can be anything that you want, and they're going to make up the red and the black portions of the design. After you have the three background images in the design, hit the new adjustment tool and then select gradient map. Click inside the black and white gradient map, and it's going to open up the gradient editor. If you hit the first color, we're going to change this to red or whatever color that you guys want to use for the design. The other color, we're going to change from white to black. Next, create an additional black color and your background should look something like this. Next, we're going to create this awesome square design look within our background. It's really easy if you just follow these steps. All you have to do is once you have the rectangle tool selected, click and drag where you want the rectangle to be. After we have all the rectangles created, insert three more background layers and we're going to put them inside our rectangles. This can be done by holding Ctrl and clicking on the layer or right clicking on the layer and then going to create clipping mask. Now that we have them inside the rectangle, let's learn how to put them all into one group. This will help with any type of organization that you have within Photoshop. You can do this by first clicking on the top layer and with the shift button held, select the bottom layer, press the folder button, and as you can see, they're all grouped into this one folder. Let's next duplicate our gradient map layer that we've already created. Right click or control click on your gradient map and then press duplicate layer. You want to now drag that duplicate layer on the top of the group that we've already created. You then want to create a clipping mask by pressing this button right here. All right, now the fun part. Import three player images that you want to be the main parts of your design. We're going to learn how to take these images and make them look super clean and professional looking within our design. All right, like we always do, let's go up to camera raw filter, but this time we're going to make a couple different changes. Increase the sharpening texture clarity as well as dehaze. Now, this is the important part. Decrease your whites, but increase the contrast and highlights. What this does is it creates like a highlighted effect on our player image. It helps it to stand out. And it's something not a lot of graphic designers are doing. You can also make some small adjustments to the curves tab within camera raw filter, but it isn't required. This is what it looked like before, and you can see how much better it looks after. I make these same adjustments for the other two images within the sports poster design. If you're looking to try this exact design out for yourself, or maybe you just want to use some of the overlays that I'm going to be using in the later part of this video, just like all my recent videos, I have left the assets in the description as a Google Drive link, and all I ask is for you to like the video so I know to keep doing videos like this. All right, let's create this red and white effect on the back of our players. First, duplicate our player by pressing Command J and then create a new adjustment layer and then go to solid color. Select the color of your choosing. For me, I went with white. Right click or control click and go to create clipping mask. Make sure this adjustment layer is right above our duplicated player image so that we can group it and put it below our main player image. Press the right arrow key 8 times so that the white effect is shown to the right of our main player image. We can now duplicate that layer, then change it to a different color. For me, I chose red, but you can choose whatever color fits your design that you're doing. You can then press the left arrow key to move your color background to the left of your main player image. This will give you an amazing looking red and white player effect within Photoshop. You can do this for all three of your player images. This is what it looked like before, and here is what it looked like after. All right, now it's time to insert some overlays. The first will be this torn piece of paper. We can throw this on darker color and it creates a slight effect on the bottom of our design. Next, drag in the two paint effects and we're going to switch the blend mode to saturation. What this does is it makes the paint gray, which creates a great looking effect within Photoshop, especially over our red background. You can mess around and duplicate these layers as many times as you want and put them into your background however you choose. Let's now insert our dust overlay and throw that on the blend mode screen. This allows for only the white parts to be showing in our graphic design. Let's also add a topographic map in this corner. Tape on our three rectangles. What I'm going to do is switch the tape to linear light and it gives it this effect so it blends more into my design. And also we're going to add a plastic image over our entire graphic. Click and drag the plastic texture and put it into your design. If you change the blend mode to lighten, you'll have something like this. Stick with me, we're gonna make some changes to this layer. Hit the mask button, and with the mask button selected, click your paintbrush, flip it to black, and then paint over the majority of this layer. I know this part is a little bit confusing, so if you have any questions, leave me a comment and I'd love to respond. You're gonna wanna do this until you get something that looks a little bit like this. All right, we're almost done. Stick with me here. You won't wanna miss this last part. Add a selective color layer and then take out the cyans. Make sure you're in the red color category. And what this does is it makes your reds just a little bit brighter. A lot of other designers like to do adjustments to every single color. And for me, I like to look what the neutrals does. So if I take away the cyans, it looks a little bit more red. So that's what I decided to do for this graphic. All right, now for the fun part. Remember that gradient map that we started out with? We're gonna do that same gradient map, but with a twist. So again, change these colors to red as well as black. And then we're gonna change this gradient map to the blend mode screen. And this actually looks pretty cool, but for this design, let's just paint back on some of this red. With your mask selected, hit Command I to invert the mask. Now paint back on with the white paintbrush to where you want more red. And to tie this whole graphic together, you can use one of my favorite techniques. Sometimes I use camera raw filter to get this done, but other times I like to just paint back on myself, and it's adding this black shadow around the outside of the graphic. It's pretty simple to do. All you need is a blank layer and then paint back on with a black paintbrush. And after you've added this, you're finished. If you have any questions about any of the steps, leave a comment below. Thanks for watching and have a good one.